Exercise 17A, 16th problem. In a cyclic quadrilateral ABCD, angle DAC, is equal to 27 degree, angle DBA is equal to 50 degree, and angle ADB is equal to 33 degree. We have to calculate angle DBC, angle DCB, and angle CAB. Angle DBC. Now arc DC subtends angle DAC and angle DBC, angles in the same segment. Therefore, angle DAC is equal to angle DBC. This is equal to 27 degree. Angle DCB. Angle DCB. Now these two angles are equal. Angle ADB and angle ACB, angles in the same segment. Therefore, this is 33 degree. Angle ACB is 33 degree. AD, arc, subtends angle DCA and angle DBA, angles in the same segment. So, angle DCA is equal to 50 degree. Therefore, angle DCB is equal to 50 plus 33, 83 degree. Now angle CAB. Now in triangle DBC, angle DBC plus angle DCB plus angle BDC, this angle is equal to 180 degree, angle sum property. Angle DBC is equal to 27 degree, angle DCB is equal to 83 degree, plus angle BDC is equal to 180 degree. Angle BDC is equal to 180 minus 27 plus 83 is equal to what? 110. So angle BDC is equal to 70 degree. Angle BDC is equal to 70 degree. We want angle CAB. Angle BDC and angle CAB are equal, angles in the same segment. Therefore, this is also 70 degree. Seventeenth problem. AB and CD are straight lines through the center O of a circle. AB and CD. That means CD is the diameter. If angle AOC is equal to 80 degree, angle AOC is equal to 80 degree, and angle CDE is equal to 40 degree, find angle DCE, this angle, and angle ABC, these two angles. Now CD is the diameter. Therefore, angle CED is the angle in the semicircle. Therefore, this is 90 degree. Now, angle ECD plus angle EDC is equal to 90. So, this should be 50. 50 plus 40 plus 90 is equal to 180, angle sum property. Now, angle AOC is equal to 80 degree means angle COB is equal to what? 180 minus 80. Linear pair. This is 100. Now, in triangle COB, angle OCB plus angle COB plus angle OBC is equal to 180, angle sum property. 100 plus 50 is equal to 150. 180 minus 150 is equal to, this is 30. Angle OBC is equal to 30 means angle ABC is equal to 30 degree. Eighteenth problem. In this figure, AC is the diameter. AC is the diameter of this bigger circle, whose center is O. A circle is described on AO as diameter. For this circle, AO is the diameter. AE, a chord of the larger circle, AE, intersects the smaller circle at B. We have to prove that AB is equal to BE. Let us join OB. In the smaller circle, AO is the diameter. Therefore, angle ABO is the angle in the semicircle. Therefore, this is 90 degree. Now, in this bigger circle, AE is the chord. OB is perpendicular to AE. Now, a perpendicular from the center of a circle to the chord bisects the chord. Therefore, AB is equal to BE. Nineteenth problem. In this figure, angle BAD is equal to 96 degree. We have to find angle BCD, this angle, and angle BFE. And we have to prove that AD is parallel to FE. AD is parallel to FE. Now, ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Therefore, angle DAB plus angle BCD, opposite angles are supplementary. Therefore, angle BCD is equal to 180 minus 96, that is 84 degree. This is 84 degree. Now, BCEF is a cyclic quadrilateral. External angle is equal to interior opposite angle. Or you can say these two are supplementary angles. Therefore, angle BC is equal to 180 minus 84, that is 96. If this is 96, then this is 84. Opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. Or you can directly say exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to interior opposite angle. Therefore, angle BFE is equal to 84 degree. Now, AD and FE are two lines cut by a transversal AF. These two are allied angles. 96 plus 84 is equal to 180. Allied angles are supplementary. Therefore, AD is parallel to FE. 19B. ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. A circle through vertices A and B. A circle through vertices A and B meets side BC at P and side AD at Q. We have to show that quadrilateral PCDQ is cyclic. Now we can see ABPQ is a cyclic quadrilateral. ABPQ is a cyclic quadrilateral. Let angle A is equal to X and angle BPQ is equal to Y. X plus Y is equal to 180 degree. Opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. Since AD is parallel to BC, QP is the transversal. Therefore, angle DQP is equal to angle BPQ. Alternate angles are equal. If angle BPQ is equal to Y, then angle DQP is also equal to Y. Now, ABCD is a parallelogram. Therefore, opposite angles are equal. If angle A is equal to X, then angle C is also equal to X. X plus Y is equal to 180. X plus Y is equal to 180. Since the opposite angles are supplementary, PCDQ is a cyclic quadrilateral. 20th problem. A parallelogram ABCD is inscribed in a circle. We have to prove that this parallelogram ABCD is a rectangle. And then we have to prove that the rhombus inscribed in a circle is a square. Here ABCD is a parallelogram. Therefore, angle A is equal to angle C. Let them be X and X. But this is a cyclic quadrilateral. Therefore, opposite angles are supplementary. X plus X is equal to 180 Therefore, x is equal to 90 degree. So these two angles are 90 degree each. Similarly, we can prove that angle B is equal to 90 degree and angle D is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, ABCD is a rectangle. Next, we have to prove that the rhombus inscribed in a circle is a square. ABCD is a rhombus. Rhombus means what? Opposite angles are equal. If angle A is equal to X, then angle C is equal to X. This is ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Therefore, 2x is equal to 180, x is equal to 90. So, these angles are 90 degree each. Angle A is equal to 90 degree, angle C is equal to 90 degree. Similarly, opposite angles are supplementary. Let them be y and y. Opposite angles are equal. Therefore, 2y is equal to 180, y is equal to 90 degree each. In a rhombus, all the sides are equal. We have proved that all the angles are 90 degree each. So this is a square.